Hi, my name is Alexander Richter, and if you're new to the channel, we tackle here topics of visual effects, animation, and games, and specifically looking at the role of a technical director. And today I'm in Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia, and I want to talk about support and service. And one of the reasons for that is because it is one of the most important elements of being and becoming a technical director. While traveling the world and talking with people from different countries, specifically for my podcast, The 21 Artist Show, where we tackle the careers and the paths of people from different backgrounds. And one of the things that always fascinated me and is also a big part of The 21 Artist Show is the career paths of people from different backgrounds. Some people came from a different country and found their way in another one. Some people come from a background that was not as artistic or visual effects, animation and games like, and some people just needed to find their voice and their style. And that is something that I want to discover by traveling the world and talking to different people. Currently, I'm traveling Asia, and it has a completely different vibe of how people work here. And one of the elements that I notice is definitely different to the Western world is how people support and serve here. And that's also the topic of today, because support and service is an important element of being a technical director. So if you think about what is the role of a technical director, it is basically two kinds. One is to find a solution for a technical problem, and two is to find ways to simplify or make even things possible. The first one is to find solution to technical problems. If you think about what does the artist do in a visual effects or animation project, they mostly create the art that will be in the final product. They will create renderings, models, shadings, lightings, animation, and that will basically be directly included in the final product. Everything they do will be seen on the screen in the final frame. Compared to that, if you think about what, for example, software developers do on the complete other side of the spectrum, they create software that allows the artist to create the art. Nothing what they do will actually end up on the screen, but all the tools that they created, all the elements that they created will be used to create the art that is there. And technical directors are basically in the middle of that. They are the bridge between a software developer and an artist. They allow artists to create by removing the hurdles that they have and creating solutions that help them to basically beat the deadline. Because one of the things of art, of course, at the end of the day, you create art in a box, which means it could be a box of deadline, it could be a box of specific style and so on. So there are restrictions in there to create the art. And most common restriction is probably money and time. And to create something on time and on budget, it is important to be able to create fast enough and streamlined enough. And that's where basically technical directors shine, and that's where the service and support element comes in. If we think about what a technical director actually does, most of the time they come to the artist's aid to support them on creating the art. For example, let's imagine we have a situation where Maya constantly crashes after like 10 minutes. Imagine it also takes 10 minutes to open the scene. So the artist can basically open the scene after 10 minutes, work for 10 minutes, and then it crashes and start the whole process again. Of course, it will take much longer to create what the artist wants to create. And of course, it will go probably over budget because the deadline or overtime has to be done to make it happen. So the first element would be here for the technical director to look at Maya in this case and to figure out what is the reason for the crash. Is there something in the scene that kind of triggers the crash? Is something interacting in the scene, maybe scripts or plugins or models that have a problem or create a problem with the software? And to figure it out, we have, of course, to understand what is currently in the scene and used, including all the plugins and scripts, and also how the DCC actually works, including workarounds and background understanding of the system itself. This means the first line of defense and the first job of the technical director is to support the artist to create the flow of work, which sometimes can be including that the technical director will actually create the art. So for example, if you are a shading artist or lighting artist, You create lighting and shading. If you are a lighting technical director or a shading technical director, you could be creating the lights in there, or you create templates or solve technical issues regarding that. So a technical director not always is only the problem solver. There are possibilities to create art, but at the end of the day, the artist's job is to create the art and the technical director's job to help the artist as much as possible. The first element would be to simplify the workflow, and that means, for example, that the technical director will create templates that the artist can use every time they open a scene. Also, they can create scripts that will simplify the process, for example, shelf, toolbar, or menu scripts that just create basically specific elements or set settings that the artist needs to set every time, and just by one press of the button, the settings are done, the resolutions are done, the frame rate is done, specific elements are imported, and that saves a lot of time and basically kind of also allows the artist to simplify their work, but also to standardize the work to the project and the project needs. The other element is to create something that doesn't exist. So of course the software is limited to what is possible, and we are able to get plugins in to increase the capability of the software. But sometimes it's important to create something that maybe is artistically to the needs of the artist. For example, a fire solver that is not 100% realistic as the plugins that are currently existing, but something that is a little bit also toonish and creatively controlled. And if you write something like that, it allows the artist to create something that matches basically the movie or the game that they are trying to fulfill. This, of course, is a little bit more on the software development side, but it can always spill over to the technical directing side. And especially to create workflows and to create new solutions, it's important to be able to script, because at the end of the day, scripting allows you access to the software and not just able to simplify things with a one-button solution, but also to be able to create something that the software generally doesn't do by itself. And one of the most important language, and if you watch any of my videos, you know that by now, is Python. So in visual effects, animation, and also games, Python is probably the strongest language. It is used in all DCCs more or less, and you can basically access the software and do things with that, especially simplifying process and doing this one button solution or creating application the artist can control and then basically straightforward go into the project and just work mostly on the art and don't have to think too much about the process, about the workflow, and so on. To summarize, a technical director's job is basically to support and serve the artist who is then able to create the art, the visual effects, animation, or games project. If you're interested to see more, check out the other videos on this channel, including the 21 Artist Show, where we talk about the careers of people in visual effects, animation, and games, including Disney, Pixar, ILM, and so on. Thank you for joining me today. I will see you on the next video. Check out my website alexanderrichtertd.com if you're interested in more content like articles, masterclasses, and coaching opportunities to work successfully in the industry.